Hello students, today we are going to read about the topic requirements of lux for various purposes. As in the previous class, we have already studied about the different types of lighting that we have discussed, like incandescent lights, CFL and LED lights. So we have also discussed which type of lighting is energy efficient and energy saver. So today let us study how much, depending upon our, what is the requirement of the lux that is required for different sizes of the rooms and for what work, which, how much amount of lux, that is we are talking about the intensity of light is calculated in lux, how much is required, that we are going to study today. So as said, lux is actually a unit of it is a unit which is used to measure the intensity of the light which is hitting the surface. Typically, when we switch on the light, we are talking about the light hitting the or in a lighting design. So, 1 lux is actually equivalent to 1 lumen per the meter square. So, they differ actually from lumen. Lumen is actually the measurement of the brightness of the it is a measurement of the brightness of the light source. So they differ from lumens. Now, what is actually lumen is, it is the SI unit for measuring luminous flux, and the lux is the SI unit for measuring the luminous intensity. Lux is for intensity measurement, and lumen is for the flux or brightness measurement. Now, what actually 1 lux is equal to 1 lumen per meter square indicates? This actually means that suppose if you have a 400 lumen bulb, okay, you bought it from the market and you have you have put it in a room of 10 meter square, okay, of surface area of 10 meter square. Now, it can be a little toilet room or a storeroom, for example. Clear? Putting that into our equation, the room is therefore an average getting a light intensity of 40 lux. Yeah. Now, suppose if you put the same equation, that is 400 lumen, if you put it here. Clear? Yeah. So, if you put here the 400 lumen, and it is how much? 10 meters square. So, how much it comes? It comes around 40 lux. Yeah. So, this is what 400 over 10, the calculation, how we got it. 400 lumen bulb, and if you are putting it in a room with 10 meter square of surface area inside, then the light intensity you are getting it as 40 lux. Yeah. Now, if you put the same bulb into a larger room, when you put into a larger room, so how much is the larger room? So, the same 400 lumen bulb, if you put in a larger room of 20 meter square, and ultimately this will be decreased to 20 lux. Yeah, so if here all of a sudden what happens is the lux level is actually dropping to 20 lux. Now, this kind is actually demonstrating, and it is obvious that bigger the room, the more will be you need to create the right light level. So, this that much is obvious that, but there are other factors also which you should consider, like the natural light which is coming inside the room, and what is the dimensions of the room, and what is the required use of the room, and other factors also you should take into consideration. And this actually creates a very a good example or a good platform where with the help of this particular lux we are able to compare the light intensity, which yeah, very much useful to calculate the light intensity of a particular room, how much you need it. Now, you can use this particular lux to create a standard which can be employed across the different buildings and uses, suddenly allowing you to compare the quality of the light from one building to another. If you want to compare, then this also this is also the things which you can do it. Clear? And the quality of lighting from one building to other building, if you want to access or if you want to analyze whether the light is sufficient for that particular purpose for what it is designed, then you can go through that. Now, you find certain other companies and companies also, or some corporates also, you find where like interior design companies, where they say which is the brightest spot in the room and which is the non-brightest spot, where you need more light in that particular room and less light is required. So making sure that your property or your residential complex or commercial or industrial looks much more brighter than you do. So how much actually the lux do you need? Now, if we look at various recommendations when it comes to lighting levels, there are different recommended intensity levels depending upon the room and the purpose of the space. Now, a room which is used for storage or storeroom, you need very low light levels. Okay, so you don't need high light levels there, you don't need bright levels. Okay, the intensity of the light, if it can be low also, it's okay. If it is a workshop where detailed work is going on, brighter light levels are needed. So these things are common sense things which you already know it, where you require more light levels and brighter light levels. But with reference to the unit lux, you should also able to calculate how much lux is needed. Depending upon that, you are going to buy the or fix the lights depending upon that. So 100, let us see which type of, depending upon the which type of space or room, how much, what is needed. So first is 100 lux. This level of light is sufficient for lifts, corridors and the staircase. Now, these are the areas where only there is a transit from one place to other and there is no much detailed work is going on, and warehouses, bulk storage places, you need only minimum light level. So 100 lux is sufficient. You are not going to read any kind of book in that particular, and it's not possible also in that particular sort of light you are able to read a particular book there. So next is 150 lux, where in case of restrooms, in case of this particular restroom, this much of brightness of light is actually needed in case of restroom and plant rooms. Requires this much of level of light because this is not particularly bright and this is not good enough for simple tasks also. Okay, it is much more better than the previous one. So 200 lux is, you can use it in the entrance areas and lobbies wherever it requires level of light, and this much 200 lux intensity of light is very much minimum for this dining area of a restroom. Next is 300 lux, where this much of area of this much intensity is required in assembly areas, village halls, and where there are some kind of get-togethers or gatherings are taking place, there 300 lux brightness is intensity of light is sufficient. The next last two are important, 500 lux, where in general office spaces, where minimum light level as general office spaces, here prolonged work on computers, machineries and reading type of work, where high strain should not be there on the eyes, clear, when you work on a computer or when you read a particular book. So in those cases, 500 lux bulbs are really needed in those kind of situations. So more than 500 lux, if you are doing the work of precise work, if you are doing then intricate kind of work where the accuracy and precision comes into picture, in those kind of areas, very high lux values is needed, near about 2000, where the detailed work is carried out. So this is usually necessary in fairly unusual circumstances, or else 500 lux is an ample amount which is quite suitable for the good kind of work where some kind of tasks are going on. Okay, but to 2000 lux you can use it, but in some circumstances only where the intricate works are done. Clear? So this is all about the topic requirement of lux for various purposes. So in the next video we'll read about that, how to determine and what are the different methods for determining the method of lighting. I hope You have understood? Thank you.